First into the tank are three doctors looking to change the face of patient care on a global scale.
My name is Dr. Raghav Murali-Ganesh.
I'm Dr. Nikhol Pooviah.
And I'm Dr. Mountain Seneviratne.
And we are the founders of a company that is going to improve cancer care on a global scale. Hi, is it Josh, is it?
Yes.
Hi, Raghav, one of the doctors. Hello, how are you going?
Good.
My goal as a doctor, and as is with many doctors, is to improve the quality of the care that is delivered in and out. One more time. I take pride in the work that I do.
Thanks for that.
And I see that this solution will improve the lives of not just one patient sitting in front of me, but perhaps hundreds of thousands, if not millions of people locally, internationally.
This is something that probably a lot of patients out there, you know, want to know about.
Living with cancer is a very isolating experience.
I think the Sharks will be really interested in this project because it's one that will really help patients. It's something that's been built out of real-world experience at the hospital.
I'm Martin, one of the residents here.
With the patient at the centre of the design process. Anything different today compared to your previous chemo session?
No, it's not that bad at the moment.
Investment from the Sharks will allow us to take this product internationally. That's where we hope the Sharks can come in and help us achieve this goal. Hi Sharks. I'm Dr. Nikhil Pooviah, this is Dr. Raghav Murali-Ganesh, and this is Dr. Martin Seneviratne. We are the founders of CancerAid. CancerAid is an app that empowers cancer patients and their caregivers. Our proposal today is for $500,000 at a pre-money valuation of $5 million, equating to 10% equity. CancerAid is already the number one cancer app in Australia, US, and UK. We are providing patients with personalized cancer information. Normally, when we see new patients in clinic, we discuss all this information verbally, but we don't necessarily provide them with anything written. CancerAid allows patients to take the app home, read the information, and digest it at their own pace. We are providing a journey organizer. This is where patients will be able to log their symptoms, medications, and their medical records. Living with cancer is a very isolating experience. So our CancerAid community, similar to Facebook, LinkedIn, and Twitter, allows patients to connect with others going through similar experiences. We want to empower patients and improve their quality of life.
CancerAid has a unique business model. We license our app across three customer segments: cancer institutions, research organizations, and private cancer specialists. This allows us to provide the app free to patients. Our year one projected revenue is $1.6 million.
Impressive.
We know each of you here can help scale our business. And that's what we want the investment for, is to actually set up sales specialists in the US and the UK. Cancer patients expect, need, and deserve timely access to the best possible care. And CancerAid aims to achieve this. Let's help improve cancer care on a global scale together. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Wow, that's very impressive, gentlemen. And just to confirm, 500,000 for 10%. So as you say, a valuation of 5 million. What brought you together on this journey? Why?
Our experience working as clinical doctors, there's various issues that we see day to day. We interact with patients, caregivers every day, and it was our solution for, you know, an archaic system that we can improve. A lot of the apps that come out, they don't know who the end user is. So they'll design a prostate cancer app for the 7-year-old prostate cancer patient who's never going to use an app. It's his daughter who comes into clinic who's going to be organising his journey. So very early on, we identified who our end user is, and that's what we've made today.
I'm like a lot of people my age have been close to cancer, and I do understand the chaos associated with suddenly being thrown. Your life suddenly changes one morning and you don't even remember, you know, half of what's being thrown at you. Is that the kind of feedback from patients that sent you this way?
Exactly. We've had such great positive feedback from what we've done.
I think the secret sauce really is the community. That's what we've found to be really sticky amongst patients. They keep logging into the app because there is a community that they can access through the app.
So walk us through that commercial model, just so we understand it. So the patient gets free access.
Yep.
Give me the commercial structure. How do you actually make money out of it?
We license the app on an annual licensing fee to institutions which provide care to cancer patients.
And does that license fee vary depending on the size of the organisation?
Exactly. We've set that licensing fee at $100,000 per cancer institution, $50,000 for a research organisation, and $5,000 to a private specialist.
So that's a fairly big buying decision, $100,000. I'm sitting there as a CFO of a cancer institution go, that's $100,000 I can't put into something else that would have helped ease the patients in this facility.
You're going to enhance the patient experience, not just with the patient, but also with the institution.
And it helps the doctors.
Exactly.
It's brilliant.
So what are your revenues to date?
$170,000 in signed term sheets.
All right, so wait a second. You don't have $170,000 in revenue yet.
Because we've signed term sheets and they've deposited prepayments totaling $10,000.
All right, this is really important because these guys are really good at not paying. I'm sorry, but the medical industry, I've got several health investments. Horrible to sell to.
I think it's an easy sell. I agree with you, generally the medical industry is a tough sell and a pain, but this is different. I can see this being huge in the US, and I know how to scale and build scalable businesses. Plus, frankly, you're making a difference in the world. That's pretty important to me in terms of where I put my money. I'm in. $500,000 for 10%.
Thank you.
Wow.
Amazing.
But I would love to work with you guys. So.
Oh, wow. Thank you. That's very nice.
So I'm certainly in. My offer is $500,000 for 10%.
Well, that's what my offer was, and I was first.
All right, well, I'm in. $500,000 for 10%.
Sounds like then I should make a bid as well. Jeez. It's just simply $500,000 for 10%.
Sure. Thank you. Thanks. Steve?
Look, to be honest, I mean, these guys are honestly never got a bloody clue about how hard this is going to be.
Oh, excuse me?
And you don't want dumb money in this.
So clearly he's going to be hard to get along with.
Okay, so can we get clarity? Where are you at? Where's Steve at?
He's out.
I'm not out.
You'll be out if they say yes to one of us.
Doctors Nick, Martin and Raghav have sparked a bidding frenzy amongst four of the sharks with their cancer aid app.
I'm in.
I'm certainly in.
I'm in.
Sounds like then I should make a bid as well.
So you've got four sharks here that have offered you, that you've given you what you want, which is $500,000 for 10%.
Remaining shark, Steve Baxter, is on the fence and yet to commit.
Okay, so can we just get clarity? Where are you at? Where's Steve at?
I'm sitting on it. I know how hard this is.
All right, so you're out.
Andrew's getting impatient.
No, I'm not. I'm just trying to get things moving, you know.
Steve?
I'm not sure you're asking for enough money, and I think actually, like in a year's time, you're going to say, well, I think we need to raise $3 million just to survive the crazy sales cycle.
Please pick well. This is tough. You're going to need some really, really good help here, okay?
Fair enough. Thank you, Steve.
I'm out, but I do wish you all the best.
So Steve's out, all the four of us are in, $500,000 for 10%. So who do you think you'd like to work with?
Can we have a think about this?
Yeah, you want to go outside and have a talk about it?
Certainly.
My personal view is this is going to be really easy. Off you go.
Okay, thank you. We'll be back in a very short time.
This is a no-brainer.
Yeah.
And I love what it does.
What are your thoughts?
That was better than we could ever have hoped for.
It's a shame Steve didn't come on board.
Going into this, we put Andrew at the top. So I think if it's only one, we should put Andrew.
This thing makes money quickly, very quickly.
They're just clever guys. Don't you want to work with clever guys?
Oh, I'm really pro Glen.
Glen would be better with customers. Trust me.
Andrew, you might have me, but I think my network, seriously, is probably the better one.
I would never dispute your network. Gentlemen, what is your decision? You've had four sharks offer you basically what you asked for, $500,000 for 10%. One shark is out. Where are you at?
We want a collection.
You want to collect sharks?
We want to pick two. Andrew and Glenn, we offer you guys 5% each for the same valuation. What we think can benefit
is that you both leverage off each other's contacts. That way we also benefit and you both also benefit. That's what I'd like. Now, if you guys can work together.
Andrew, we need to make a quick little chat.
I don't need a moment. I'll give you 500,000 for 9%.
It's not the money.
Okay, 500,000 for 11%.
Okay.
It is about
it is slightly about the money as well.
Okay,
but
just
it's about the contacts. We'd like you guys to work together.
Yeah. It's just not enough equity, 20%.
But your percentage growth will be higher with another person on board, as would ours. It sounds like Glen might be keen to work with you. We'd be keen to work with both of you guys.
So there's no way you'll take one of us?
We want to.
Will you walk out without a deal tonight if you
We won't walk out without a deal because that's stupid, I think. So we want to. We want both you guys. In my head, I know that your equity will raise higher if both of you are involved. That's my genuine belief.
It's not enough equity. I think you've got to make a decision one or the other.
All right, I'm back in.
So he said he's out.
I'm not out.
He said he was out.
I'm with Glen. Just think about that for a second.
We probably need a moment just to discuss whether I want to work with him.
Just imagine what those board meetings are going to be like.
Come on, guys, this is a medical app that impacts people's lives.
That's why I got in straight away, Steve.
Andrew and Glen, you guys believe in us. You've been very supportive. So if you guys can work together, let's do it now. We'll do the deal.
Glen?
You want to work with me?
Okay, I'm good. All right, we've done the deal.
Done.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Good to meet you.
I am so proud of you guys.
We can't wait to grow as a business, you guys. Fantastic.
You're on your way, guys.
Thank you, guys.
Good luck. Let's go help some patients. Amazing.
That was great.
Boom. They tick all the boxes for me.
That pitch had to be one of the most difficult pitches we've ever done. We're really looking forward to working with Glen and Andrew. It's going to be great.
So having them on board will grow this business. There's no doubt about that for us.
I think we can work together.
No, I think we can, but I just want you to know that this is cancer for people, not animals, OK?
Yes, I know.
Just wanted to remind you.